Salut YouTube! Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be telling you all the things that I think France does way better than the USA. I got a lot of comments on my French Culture Shocks video, and a lot of people were upset about the way I depicted France, even though I was just speaking from my own experiences. So I thought it would be fun to come on here and make this video and tell you guys all of my favorite things that I prefer in France and that I think France does a way better job at than the USA. Oh, number one is the lifestyle. I think the lifestyle is so much more chill and laid back in France than it is in the States. Americans live to work and the French work to live. This is very, very evident. The French working schedule usually is about 35 hours per week, and 6 weeks of paid vacation is the standard for any job you have, for the most part. And in America, it's not like that at all. You're working 40 hours a week, and usually you have like 2 weeks paid vacation per year, if you have a good job. Not all jobs are like that, so some jobs you don't have any guaranteed vacation days. So yeah, I definitely appreciate the French lifestyle in that regard. And I also like that the vacation times are kind of the same throughout the year, just for the country as a whole. So it's really easy to plan vacations with your friends or with your family, because you know that you have the same 6 weeks of vacation off during the year as everybody else. Next is better quality food. I really like that there's a specialty store for each type of food. So if you need bread, you go to the boulangerie, because they are specialized in making bread and they know their craft and they know how to make it really well. If you need meat, you go to the boucherie, because it's the same thing. He knows his craft, he knows each cut of meat, he knows specifically how to give you the best quality. Same thing with cheese. If you need cheese, you go to the fromagerie. There's a specific specialty store for each thing that you need, and I really appreciate that in France, because I think it shows that they take those things really seriously. They take quality really seriously, and they only want to provide the best quality. And so they have these specialty stores with the people who know exactly what they're doing and how to give you the best quality food that you're requesting. I also like how they have food grades on each food item. This is something that I've only recently noticed. I've been in France like almost 2 years now, and I just noticed this. But anytime you go to the grocery store, there's a little food grade on the bottom of the packaging, and it'll either be A if it's a really good quality, really healthy food, and it varies all the way to E. So E is like really bad quality, junk food, lots of sugar, bad food that you shouldn't be eating. And each food item has this grade on it. So I really like this, because you can go to the supermarket and pick up an item and know exactly what's in this item and if it's good for you or bad for you. I think a lot of the times, people who don't necessarily know what's in certain items may be buying an item that they think is healthy and they think is good quality, but it's actually really not. So I like that France has these food grades, because it makes everything really transparent and people know exactly what they're buying, and they can make the choice if they want to eat good quality food or if they want to buy that not so great junk food item. Also, of course, the wine. One of my favorite things about France, there's so many different types of wine and it's so cheap, but even the cheap wine is still really good quality, because France is just known for having so much wine that it's still such a great quality. Here in the States, if you buy cheap wine, you're getting really bad cheap quality wine, and you can really taste the difference. There, it's not uncommon to spend 4 or 5 euros on a bottle of wine and have it actually be a decent quality. Along with the quality of food brings me to my next really, really important thing that I think France does way better than the US is healthcare. I'm sure most of you know that the US healthcare system is terrible. It's a nightmare. It's so expensive. You have to pay for your healthcare every month, and depending on how much coverage you have, whether you have pre-existing conditions, it can get really expensive. Here in France, I've never had to worry about that. Anytime I have to go to the doctor, I usually pay a 20 euro copay when I get there, and then my insurance reimburses me for that after the doctor's visit. So I really don't pay anything. Usually pay a small copay, and then whatever I have to pay for the pharmacy prescription, usually like 20, 30 euro, and that's it. And I don't have to worry about getting a huge bill in the mail, or if I'm feeling really sick, I don't have to tell myself I can't call the ambulance or I can't go to the hospital because I'm gonna be stuck with a huge bill. And that is probably the biggest thing that I prefer in France over the US is because I've met a lot of people who are in tons of debt because of medical bills in the States, and it's just really sad. And so it's just really such a relief to live in a place that prioritizes its citizens and sees healthcare as a right and not a privilege. And it's honestly such a huge weight off of my shoulders to live in a place knowing that if I get sick, I can be seen by a doctor and I don't have to worry about being in a ton of debt afterwards. Also, the quality of healthcare is really good. Recently, I learned that France has the number 2 healthcare system in the world, which I was really impressed to hear. I think Italy was number 1, France is number 2. So that just goes to show that just because the healthcare here is affordable and citizens don't pay for it, doesn't mean it's bad quality. It's actually really good quality care that you're getting here. So I really appreciate that about France. Next is the ease of travel. It is so easy to travel in France, not only around Europe in general from France, but within France itself. There's so many different types of public transportation. France has a really good train system. You can get anywhere in the country by train. It's super affordable, it's super fast, and honestly, I love it. It's great. I think one thing that I really appreciate about living in France is how much transportation is available, because it's so different from what I'm used to living back in the US. If you don't have a car there, in most cases, depending on where you live, if you don't live in a huge city like New York City or San Francisco, if you don't have a car, then you're pretty much stuck. There's buses, but there's not really a good bus system. We don't have very many trains. So I really appreciate that France is on top of their game and they have so many transportation options and they're so affordable and so reliable. The next is work and rental contracts. One thing that I really admire about France is the protection that they give to their workers. So in France, if you sign an employment contract, you're pretty much in that contract until you quit. It's really difficult for French companies to just fire you. They have to have a good reason. They have to go through a process, do a bunch of documentation. So for the most part, when you sign a work contract, you're pretty much set for as long as you want to work in that position. Whereas in the States, if you guys don't know, you can be fired like that. You can show up to work one day and your boss can tell you, it's not working, you've got to go, and you're done like that. There's no protection, no warning. They can fire you at any time and you'll just be left without a job. So I like that France takes a little more care and protects their citizens a little bit better. This goes with rental contracts as well. Once you sign a rental contract, it's really hard for the landlord to get out of that contract. They can't increase the prices on you. I think they have to give you like a certain amount of notice or something like that. If they want to sell their property to someone else, they have to wait until your lease is up before they can sell that property. They can't just say, hey, I'm selling this property, sorry, you've got to move out, which they can do in the States. So I really appreciate that. This does make things a little more difficult initially when you're trying to get a job or trying to get a rental contract, because once it's signed, like, you're stuck in there for life pretty much. So it can make things a little more difficult when you're searching initially, but once you get in, you're in for the long haul. Another thing I really like about France is that the people here seem to be more educated and more cultured. I think France puts a huge emphasis on education, and it's more of a priority here than it is in the States. In the States, education is severely underfunded. It's not something that the government really sees as very important, unfortunately. They spend their resources other places like military and police, things like that, whereas education is left underfunded. Here in France, I think people are more educated, they're more cultured. I think they learn a lot more about the world and they know things about history, about art, about politics, whereas Americans don't really learn anything outside of American history. French people are more cultured and more versed on history of other countries and other parts of the world. And of course, I have to show love to all the architecture and history that there is in this beautiful country. There's so many beautiful buildings and so much stunning architecture all around France. They're so proud to preserve the original architecture, which I really like. You can walk down the street and literally picture what life was like 200, 300 years ago, because for the most part, it looks exactly the same as it always has. I really like that they're not trying to modernize everything and that they really think it's important to preserve the culture and the original architecture of the country. In fact, there's only one skyscraper in Paris, which is Montparnasse Tower, And when it was first built, the Parisians hated it. Nobody liked it. And after that, they were not allowed to build any more skyscrapers in Paris. So that's like a law for Paris. They have to keep all the original architecture. They're not allowed to build any skyscrapers in Paris so that they can preserve what it looks like. There is the La Défense, the business region, but technically it's not in Paris. It's just right outside of the city. So that's why they can get away with building tall buildings and modern skyscrapers and stuff. But in Paris, all the architecture has to remained in the same style. This is very different from the houses here in the US because for the most part in any given neighborhood, most of the houses look the same. It's usually like five different models of homes, and then every other house will be like the same in a neighborhood. So there's not really any like creativity or diversity. So I really like that in France. Everything has its own style and its own flair, and all the architecture for the most part is preserved and looks exactly like it did when it was first built. So there you have it, you guys. Those are the things that I think France does better than the USA. Leave a comment down below and tell me if there's anything in this video that surprised you about France that you maybe didn't know before that you learned today. I'd be interested to hear about it. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them down below. I hope you guys have a great week, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.